हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल गार्डनिंग इज माय लव। टुडे आई एम कमिंग अप विद द न्यू प्लांट विच इज इन द हर्बल सेक्शन। सो यू कैन सी दिस प्लांट, दिस इज कॉल्ड भूमि आमला इन हिंदी। इफ यू आर फ्रॉम कर्नाटका यू फाइंड दिस प्लांट एवरीवेयर इन द पैडी फील्ड्स एंड आउटसाइड एवरीवेयर एंड ऑल ओवर द कोस्टल रीजन। दिस प्लांट इज यूजुअली ग्रोन इन द रेनी सीजन। सो आई हैव कलेक्टेड ए फ्यू प्लांट्स फ्रॉम द गार्डन। You can see the plants, very lush green in color. You can see the plants. Yeah, it is called as Bhumi Amla. And if you see the plant leaves, you can see a gooseberry like structure, small gooseberries. So therefore it is called as Nela Nelli or Bhumi Amla. Amla means gooseberry. So you can see. So now this plant is in many varieties. So what you can see here in this plant, you can see all these amlas are in white color, white or green, a stem is green, and some variants of these plants are there in bit reddish in color. So most of the plants produce the same medicinal properties, one may vary in some way. So now let me come to the use of this plant. Yeah, this is a magic plant. Usually it is used in many Ayurvedic medicines. You can find in Bangalore, you can find it in Karnataka, all over. I am not sure about the northern part of India, but even in Andhra Pradesh it is found. So it is called as Nela Nelli, yeah, in our local language. So now let me come to the second part. This I have collected a few days back. So they are growing in these two pots. I put some cocopeat. So now you can make decoction from the plant. You can use the entire plant. Suppose if you are plucking a plant from your garden, you pluck it from the garden, wash the roots nicely and use the entire plant for making the decoction or juice. The roots contain the highest nutrient or Ayurvedic property, and even the leaves. So now what you can do is fold this plant. Yeah, so I'm not folding it, you can fold like this. Yeah, or put it in a smasher and put inside, and you can smash and make a paste out of it. You can make a paste. So this is one way. Or clean the plant nicely, so you can make a paste, crush it and make paste. Yeah, so this is one way you can do. And the second way is you can cut the leaves properly, make it into small pieces and put it in a mixture. So put it in the mixture and grind it using some water. Now how to make decoction, I will just explain you the method. First you take few plants, depends on your need. Don't take too many plants, 2-3 plants you take. Cut them into pieces. Yeah. Mash them and make paste out of it, and take 3-4 glasses water, depends on the quantity of Bhumi Amla you have taken. So now next is the next step is you can even use jeera, that is cumin seeds, or you can use jaggery. So to taste the juice better, you can use jaggery. So the procedure is, first you make the paste, yeah, as much as possible make the paste, 3-4 glasses water you can take, yeah, put this paste when the water is boiling to a certain temperature, put the paste in the water, and next step is you can add jaggery, you can add the cumin seeds, yeah, and the entire mixture, you can boil it to a certain temperature till the water becomes half. Suppose if you have taken 4 glasses water, till the water evaporates and becomes 50%, that is 2 glasses, boil it. Maybe around 15 minutes it will take on a medium flame. So after that what you do is filter the water nicely, yeah, filter that juice, and even you can add 1 glass of or half a glass of milk, it does not matter, but without milk also you can consume. So that is how you make the decoction, and that is one way of doing it. Next is you can straight away go to the garden, pluck a few leaves, yeah, and you can simply consume. There is no problem. On an empty stomach, if you consume it, is very very good for your health. And there are many ways of using it. You can simply crush this plant, make a juice of the whole plant, take 10 to 15 ml, store it in a refrigerator and consume twice a day, so two times in a day. And final step, let me just explain you the benefits of this plant in the Ayurvedic world. So first benefit is it is very helpful for anemic conditions. So those with anemic condition, bloodlessness, yeah, in those conditions this plant is very very useful. And the second one is this plant is a magic plant for jaundice or hepatitis B. So if you consume the juice of this plant for 10 to 15 days, yeah, you can keep away your jaundice. Next, even those who have stones in their bladder, yeah, this plant, another name we call it as a stone breaker. Yeah, some people have kidney stones, yeah, renal stones. So this plant helps in crushing those stones, yeah, without the surgical procedure. And there are many uses from this plant, and I have collected a few plants. If you are from this part of the region, during the rainy season, this plant is very very common. Anywhere in the paddy fields you can find. Now it is called as Bahupatra in Sanskrit, which means it is cure for many ailments, and in the Ayurvedic world this is used in a different way. So now there are many other uses. Those who feel sleeplessness, even if you take little juice, yeah, those who feel over thirsty, yeah, and even those who have stomach ailments, if you have skin disorder, yeah, you can make the paste and apply on your skin. So these are some of the uses of this particular plant. But this plant is very good for jaundice, kidney stones, renal stones, any problem in the bladder, jaundice, yeah, liver disease. So please make a juice, yeah, and share it with your family. So thank you for watching my channel. If you are not subscribed, yeah, please subscribe to my channel by pressing the bell icon. Yeah, stay happy, stay healthy. This is my channel is Gardening is My Love. Continue to watch the channel. So thank you very much.